Hello everyone, today I am going to explain all about tree set. Tree set is used to store the group of unique values. Just like a asset, tree set does not allow duplicate values and it stores the element in a ascending order. It is derived from the set and sorted set interface. So because of this, it is getting all the properties and methods from the set and sorted set interfaces. And also tree set is having some own properties and methods. Tree set internally use a tree map for storing the elements. So coming to the important points, tree set does not maintain insertion order. Elements are stored in tree set is in ascending order. Tree set does not allow duplicate values. That means it is having only unique elements. Tree set is not synchronized. That's why at a time multiple thread can perform operation on a tree set object. Tree set is faster for accessing the element. So suppose if you want to access the element in a fast manner, we can use the tree set. Now coming to the methods of tree set. So add method. Add method is used to add the element into the tree set object. Add all method. Add all method is used to add the collection of element into the tree set. Remove method. Remove method is used to remove the element from the tree set object. Remove all method. Remove all method is used to remove all the element from the tree set. First method. First method is used to return the first element of the tree set. So last method. Last method is used to return the last element of the tree set. Contents method. Contents method is used to check the specified element is present in the tree set or not. If it is present, it returns true. Otherwise, it will return false. IsEmpty method. IsEmpty method is used to check if the tree set is empty or not. So if it is empty, it will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. Size method. Size method is used to check if the size of the tree set. So clear method. Clear method is used to clear the element from the tree set object. Now coming to the how we can create the tree set. Tree set equal to new tree set. So here we are creating the tree set object. So operations on a tree set. How to add element into tree set? So here we are creating the tree set object and I am adding the four element into the tree set object. So now I am creating one more tree set object and I am adding two more elements into the tree set object. So here I am using the add all method to add all the element into the tree set one. So here tree set elements are added into the tree set one. So how to iterate the element from the tree set? Here we are using the iterator interface to iterate the element from the tree set. So here we are creating the iterator interface object. So here we are checking either the iteration is having next element or not. If it is containing the next element, it will print the next element. Otherwise, it will not print. So how to remove the element from the tree set? Here we are using the remove method to remove the element from the tree set object. How to remove all the element from the tree set? We can use remove all method to remove all the element from the tree set. So how to retrieve first element from the tree set? Here we are using the first method to retrieve the element from the tree set and here we are printing. So how to retrieve last element from the tree set? We can use the last method to retrieve the last element of the tree set. So how to check element is present in the tree set or not? We can use the contents method to check if the given element is present in the tree set or not. If it is present, it will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. How to check the tree set is empty or not? We can use isEmpty method to check if the tree set is empty or not. So if it is empty, it will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. So how to find the size of the tree set? We can use the size method of tree set to find the size of the tree set. How to clear the element from the tree set? We can use the clear method to clear the element from the tree set. Now I am going to show you the simple example of tree set. Just go to Eclipse, select class and class name is tree set example. Just to select the public static void. So here I am going to remove the unwanted comments. Import the java.util package because all the collection class and interface available in a util package. Now I am going to create the tree set object. So here just we can use the tree set object. Here we are creating the tree set object, and I am going to add the element into the tree set. So first I am going to add the knock. I am adding knock, and I am going to add 3 more elements. So name is Raju and Hari, and finally I am adding Babu. So here I am going to print the preset object. So here we can see the output of a preset. So here we can see all the 4 elements are printed. Now I want to use the addAll method. So that's why I am going to create one more preset object, and the object name is preset 1. So here I am using add of, I want to add 3. I am adding one more element into the preset. So I want to add one more element, Vasu. So here now I am going to use the addAll method. So now I am using, first I am going to print the preset 1. So here we can see, so here the preset contain 4 elements, preset 1 contain 2 elements. Now I am going to use the all add method, addAll method. So here I want to use addAll. So just I am using preset 1 dot addAll of. So here we have to pass the collection object. I am passing the preset. So now we can see how many elements are added into the preset 1. So here we can see both 4 elements plus 2 elements, 6 elements are adding into the preset 1 because we are using the addAll method. So now I am going to use the iterator to iterate the element from the tree set. So here iterator equal to yashed dot iterator. So here I am going to use while method, while iter dot as next method. So it will check the iteration interface contain the next element or not. If it is contain, it will return the next element. So here we can use iterator dot next method. So it will return the next element. Now I am going to print the element. So just run the application. Here it is printing 4 elements because we are using only preset. So now I am going to use the, I want to use remove method. So here I am going to use remove method, preset dot remove off. I want to remove Hari. So here I am printing the preset. Here we can see Hari is present in the preset or not. So Hari is not there, Hari is removed from the preset. So now I am going to use the remove all method. Just I am using boolean value equal to, I just use preset dot remove all. So here remove all, I can pass the preset 1. So here I can use preset. Now I am going to print the value, and I am going to print the reset. Here we can see like this will return true. That means it is remove all the element from the tree set. Here we can see all the element from the tree set. So for meanwhile we are commenting this one because we have to do other operation. So now I am going to use first method. So because of that I am using just string first equal to tree set dot first. Just here I am printing first. Here we have to convert typecasting into tree. Just I am printing. So here we can see it will return the first element of the tree set. So here contain first element is Babu, that's why it returns first element. Now I am going to use the last element. Here I am using the last method. So here we can see I am going to print last. So here we can see last method is Raju. Here it is the Raju is the last method, that's why it is written last element. So and I am going to check I want to check if the specified element is present in the tree set or not. That's why I can use the contains method. So I want to check 3 is present in the tree set or not. That's why I am using. Now I am going to print the tree set. Here we can use just like here it will return false because 3 is not there in the cache. That's why I want to check either Bobby is present in the tree set or not. So now I am going to use. So here it is return true because Bob is present in the tree set. Next one is I want to check the tree set is empty or not. That's why I can use tree set dot is empty. So if it is return true, the tree set is empty. If it returns false, tree set contains elements. It is returns false, that's why tree set contains the elements. Now I want to find the size of the tree set. I can use size method to find out the size of the tree set. I just run. Here we can see 3. So now I am going to use clear method to clear the element from the tree set. Just I am printing the tree set. So now we can see all the elements are cleared from the tree set. So if you print the tree set, it is written empty. That means all the elements are removed from the tree set. So friends, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching this video.